It's hard for me to believe that we've completed our centennial celebration. We're in our 101st year and we're planning for the 21st century at the University of La Verne. As I look back at those 101 years, I see a thread weaving through our history. That thread is our emphasis on academic quality. These magnificent oak trees have become an important symbol at the University of La Verne. They symbolize strength and tradition and heritage. They look like they've been here forever, and it's hard to believe that they were actually planted 30 years after our founding. But the seeds of academic excellence were planted in 1891. From this tower in 1905, President W.C. Hanawalt could view the entire campus of the University of La Verne, a single building, the Lordsburg Hotel. Today, President Hanawalt would need a map of the world to review the programs of the University of La Verne.
Shut out the Pirates 2-0. He lives and works in Conyers, Georgia. Wonderful guy, Danny McDevitt. He was a character. By the way, we sure want to take a minute and thank Annette Norris in Brent Shire's office for all her help doing some research to help us out on Where Are They Now. She certainly went above and beyond the call of duty. So, Annette, thanks so very much.
I was so surprised, I almost fell off the couch. And then the phone started ringing with people who were also watching the game, who knew me, who'd heard my name. And so I couldn't even watch the rest of the game. We were so excited. We rushed into the phone, talking to people. The call waiting beeped, and other people were on the line. It was really very exciting. It was very nice of him to do that.
Well, related to your job, what do you do for the Dodgers?
I work in broadcasting and publications. Those are two different departments, really, that are in the same office for the Dodgers. On the broadcasting side, we deal with all of the rights holders, the broadcasting rights holders. And on the publication side, we actually produce all of the publications that the Dodgers publish for the fans and the media guide, which is for the baseball writers and the broadcasters. So it's really all of the communications for the Dodgers comes out of our office. I feel very lucky to have gone to the University of La Verne. I do think that I was very well prepared for my job.
Investment that you make in your life is hopefully going to pay back for you one day. And so far, the investment that I've made in La Verne has already started paying back for me.
I just learned so much about myself, about other people, about human nature and group interaction. It was that all that, I think, gives someone a particular self-confidence because they learn something about themselves and about other people.
I have to say these last 3.5 years have definitely been the best years of my life. La Verne specifically, I would say, I don't think I could have chosen a better college experience.
I'm glad that I'm here, especially now after it's like over, because that family, that La Verne family that my parents felt so close to for so long and introduced me to is now, you know, my family too.
La Verne is a pioneer in offering off-campus educational opportunities. We offer programs throughout the state of California, in Alaska, in Italy, and in Athens. In fact, our program in Athens is a very large program of both graduate and undergraduate studies. Because our full-time faculty are involved in all of our programs, the programs we offer off-campus are every bit as high quality as the ones we offer on-campus.
And I'm with the Central Valley Cluster. I'm superintendent of schools for the Los Banos Unified School District in Central California. And the group I represent this morning is women.
Our people are already leaders in their organizations. They're already principals, assistant superintendents, college deans, some college presidents. They're already active leaders in their organizations. And one of the things we feel strongly is they have to be sensitive to the emerging changes in culture in California and the United States. California is a highly pluralistic state, and we have to be sensitive to that. So we were concerned about them becoming knowledgeable about a lot of different kinds of groups. But beyond that, they needed to feel something about that. They needed to have a sensitivity to it that came from inside.
We learned that it is hard to live and feel the needs of another culture, and even harder to maintain sensitivity once we have learned the issues. It takes work initially to avoid the stereotypical remarks and innuendos. I cannot even leave here today with a certainty that all in my group who were sensitized to the needs of women will internalize these learnings. I can, however, leave knowing that 19 stereotypical males in the ULV doctoral program agreed in closing today to reflect on our experiences, to think about our comments, and to be mindful of women's needs.
Because see, we are all Americans too. We recognize that some of them served in the service. But they didn't want to listen. Walked up to a white male and said, listen, I was in Vietnam, weren't you? Yeah, I was in the Marine Corps. But he rejected us. We fought for the same thing, this American flag. And I'm trying to figure out to this day, why did he reject me?
You have the 76-year-old woman who goes to the doctor and she has a real pain in her arm. And she says she has a pain in her arm and the doctor says, well, you're 76 years old, what do you expect? You should have aches and pains. And she says, this arm's 76 years old too. It works just fine. The care that we're getting is not good enough. There are not specialists in gerontology. They don't know what they're looking for, and what's more, most of them don't care. It needs to change.
And I noticed that in his aggression and assertiveness, he was more powerful negotiating for women than women are negotiating for each other. And that was powerful. And it was because it doesn't matter what role we assume, the power is in the person.
My question for you, as we reflect on our learnings and our needs and our differences, what have you individually, personally done, or said, or not done, or not said, that has made the gay or the lesbian here in this room feel that they must stay hidden? What have you done to enable them to be themselves?
May God give us wisdom and lots of it, and much compassion and plenty of grit, so that we may be kinder to those who sit on the other side of the desk.
We don't recruit a great deal for our program. Our students recruit because they're proud of their experience and they want other people to have that same experience and other people they value. So they recruit very good people for us.
I have found it to have strengthened the work that I do. I'm in education, public school education, and every day I use some strategy, some technique, some learning that I've gleaned from this program.
That's the glory of La Verne University doctoral program. They take you out of the world of theory and make it practical. And hopefully all of us in the program will go back to our schools with an appreciation and an added sensitivity to different groups so that we realize, you know, that differences are to be respected.
It's a blend of theory and putting it to application. And in the La Verne program, you use all of the things that you're taught in your daily life as an administrator, as an educational leader. I don't know of any other programs that do that.
And what this program does is assure that you learn the theory and then make you go through activities which make the theory mean something to people. It's a very powerful program, and I'm really glad I'm in it.